Now, dear students, today we are discussing one new point. What are vapors? What is vaporization? Now, here we take three containers A, B, C. In these three containers, please see carefully. We add equal quantity of water in these three containers. Now we keep them in outside where we are having sun radiations. After 2 hours or 3 hours, notice the amount of water left. We shall notice in beaker A, water has decreased. Quantity of water in A has decreased maximum. Here water quantity decreased, but not so much as compared to A. And in C, quantity of water has decreased to very small amount. Decreased to very small amount. It shows that in it water disappeared maximum as compared to this, as compared to this. That water which disappeared from container A, container B, container C has been converted into vapors, and it is called vaporization. It is called vaporization. What is the definition of vaporization? The conversion, the change of any liquid into vapors at, here it is important, all temperatures. Is called vaporization. Now, what is vaporization? Vaporization takes place at all temperatures, and vaporization takes place only at surface. Vaporization is surface phenomena. It takes place at all temperatures. More the surface area. Now, important is more the surface area, faster is vaporization. And such liquids which are converted into vapors easily, what are they called? They are called volatile liquids. Volatile. Liquids are converted into vapors easily. And those liquids which do not convert into vapors easily, they are called non-volatile. Liquids. Majority organic liquids are volatile in nature. Non-volatile liquids, they are not converted into vapors. Now, when these are converted into vapors in a closed container, please now, if you go to your kitchen, your mother is boiling some liquid in a pressure cooker. You must have noticed after 10-15 minutes, there starts whistling from pressure cooker. Pressure cooker ke upar se whistle upar uthti hai. And steam comes outside. What is that steam? That is called vapors. Because in pressure cooker, more vapors have dwelt. They put the pressure on the container. They come outside with more power. That force exerted by the pressure dwelt by vapors over the liquid in a closed container is called vapor pressure. Now, dear students, in first chapter of 9th class, we started with three states of matter: solid, liquid and gas. Solids do not flow, but two types of solids are there: true solids and not true solids are also called amorphous solids. Some amorphous solids can flow. It is slightly higher level point. Glass can flow at its own weight. Please, it is important. Glass is amorphous solid and glass can flow. Solids have stronger intermolecular forces as compared to liquids, as compared to gases. Again, there are two types of liquids: volatile liquids and non-volatile liquids. We cannot compress any liquid. Liquids cannot be compressed. Liquids flow from higher level to lower level. But gases can flow in all directions. You start burning any kind of candle, any kind of perfume in your room. You burn an agarbatti, keep it at the low level in a room. Within 1-3 minutes,
its vapors will spread in all room, and we shall get smell in all directions. Mean on gases important is there is no effect of gravity. There is no effect of gravity. Again, there are three types of scales to measure the temperature. What are those scales? Centigrade, Fahrenheit, and Kelvin. Kelvin, when centigrade is to be converted into Kelvin, add 273 plus centigrade. Relation between centigrade and Fahrenheit is C by 5 equal to F minus 32 upon 9. In this way, we can convert any temperature into any relation, centigrade, Fahrenheit, and Kelvin. Now, what is melting point? Is a temperature at which a solid melts is called melting point. What is boiling point? It is the temperature at which a liquid boils. Now, important is when we boil the water, we take a beaker, we add water, we start heating it. When water boils, we get steam. Which is more harmful? It is a question with answer. Which is more harmful, boiling water or steam? Answer is steam, because when water boils, when it is converted into steam, boiling water gains some energy from heating instrument, and then it is converted into steam. Therefore, steam has more energy than boiling water. Temperature of both is same, but it has escaped with more energy. Therefore, steam is more harmful than boiling water. Again, you take some perfumed liquid in your hand. It evaporates. When it evaporates, please, it is question with answer. When any perfumed liquid evaporates from our hand, it takes some energy from our hand to escape. To convert into vapors, it takes some energy. Therefore, our hand feels cooling. Therefore, it is called evaporation causes cooling. This was brief discussion of first chapter of 9th class. Thank you, please.